Have a look at these. And what are we supposed to do with these?
Put them on your head, stupid Christ. If you think I'm going to turn up here clean shaven and greet them with a grin on my face, you've got another thing coming. Now these fellas, they're your neighbours. I thought it might be a good idea to disguise ourselves a little.
Right. Yeah, good thinking, so. Well done.
I brought weapons as well.
Weapons? What do you mean, weapons?
These?
Jesus! Let's keep them covered up, eh? Can you got anything a bit bigger?
What? Well, that?
Okay. I think you need help. Bar steward, can we have a couple of drinks, please?
Have you seen your dad? Atchett sent one of his men round.
Oh, shit. When? Crazy. Where did you get these?
What's going on, ladies and gents in Cyberland? Coming back to you with another film review, and this time we're moving on to I would say it's the first in the trilogy of the Guy Ritchie crime comedy that he's done, because they're not connected but they feel connected. So Lock, Stock, and Two Smoking Barrels. So, this film follows a quartet of young men, and one of them tries to get them paid. Like, he gambles some money that they have. Unfortunately, the guy they're gambling with is a fucking cheat and doesn't play fair. Of course, they don't know that, and they lose, and they end up owing a lot of money in British pounds. So much that the guy pretty much says, either you pay me, you get my money, or you're a dead duck. All four of them. So the film just follows them trying to find a way to get the money, and they need to pay this guy off, even though this guy has his hands in so much debauchery. And then we have a cast of characters in here. And then the funny thing is, when I first watched this film, I didn't realize, oh shit, it's Sting. You know, Sting, if you know who the Police are, the band The Police, the lead singer of the Police is in this movie, Sting. So I was like, hey man, is that Sting? Nah, that's not Sting. That's not him. It is. And I was just like, oh, snaps. It's one of the first times I can recall that I've ever seen him in a film. And he was pretty cool. He was very laid back. You know, he did a damn good job of the character. Because he's actually one of the characters of the quartet. But he did a good job. I enjoyed him for what his screen time was. And the film has comedy, I would say more so British comedy than American comedy. It's pretty good though. It has violence, it has naughty language, it has, the only thing it doesn't have is romance. It has double crossing between double crossing after double cross after double cross. It has a little some nihilism in it, and just kind of like unexpected turns that happen one after another. It's kind of really interesting. And the funny thing is, when you watch this film and then you go see Snatch, there's a lot of elements that were grabbed from Lock, Stock and were applied to Snatch. Not necessarily characters, but just incidents that you like. The I guess you could say the gravity of the mitigating circumstances of Lock, Stock gets applied again in Snatch with different circumstances. And a couple characters from, or actors from Lock, Stock end up being in Snatch. Two of them, actually three, no, four. I would say at least four people from Lock, Stock ended up being, five. Five people from Lock, Stock ended up being in Snatch. But, you know, overall, it's just very entertaining. My rating for the film, I would give it an 8.5 out of 10. Yes, sirs. For what it was, I think for what Guy Ritchie started out with and where he went moving forward with other films, it's a good introduction to his work. I felt the quartet was cool, but maybe the characters could have been fleshed out a little more so. Maybe. I enjoyed the characters from The Gentleman and Snatch a lot more than the characters in here. But that doesn't take away from this film. It's still a great film. It's just, if Ritchie had never done Snatch or Gentleman, then I would probably not compare this to those, because those films are just, damn, they really are. So yeah, it's a great film, great introduction for Ritchie from what I've seen. Enjoyed it very much, and I would say, you know, make sure if you watch it, you pay attention, because if you don't pay attention, it's a film that kind of little bit of, you know, you need some little thought to pay. You know, you can't just kind of be like on your phone or doing other things and be like, what's going on? Because then you got to watch the film from beginning to end. You can't take breaks and do other things. You know, make some time, sit down and watch it. And then after that, then you can go do your thing. But this is not a film where you can just turn on the background and hope to get it. So with that being said, I will catch you guys on the next one. Take care.